Live via satellite from the exciting capital city of Manila in the Philippines. The 1994 Miss Universe pageant. Leading our grand possession is the reigning Miss Universe, Dianara Torres. And now meet the two former title holders from the Philippines.
Hi, I'm Gloria Diaz, Miss Universe 1969.
I'm Margarita Moran, Miss Universe 1973.
It's evening in the USA and 8 o'clock in the morning here in Manila, where our live pageant is about to begin.
So welcome to the Philippine International Convention Center.
And to our beautiful country.
And as we say in the Philippines,
Mabuhay! Welcome!
The 1994 Miss Universe pageant. Starring 77 of the most beautiful women in the world. With your host, Entertainment Tonight, Bob Nolan. Your co-host from Entertainment News Television, Arbel Neville. Special commentator, Miss Universe 1989, Collins Angela Visser. The reigning Miss Universe, Puerto Rico, Dianara Torres. The Little Sisters of the Philippines, the Bayanihan Philippine Dance Company, and special guest star singer Vivo Bryson. And now, here are the 77 contestants for the title of Miss Universe 1994.
It's a little weird, isn't it?
It's a little weird.
I'm wearing my pajamas under my tux, with the feet in them too. Well, we want to thank all the dancers, the great dancers, the Bayanihan dancers and the Obusan dancers. They were terrific. And thank you, ladies. Mabuhay.
I tell you what, your national costumes are just fantastic, spectacular.
And welcome all of you to the 43rd annual Miss Universe pageant. Welcome, everybody.
That's right.
You know, Bob, this is somewhat of a historic occasion because the pageant was broadcast from here in Manila exactly 20 years ago.
That's right, it was. Well, Miss Universe said then, we shall return, and we did.
Yeah, but I think General MacArthur may have said it first, though.
Yeah, well, he didn't copyright it, so there you go. Yeah. You're going to be up in the anchor booth, right?
Oh, yes, and I have a lady up there who knows everything. She's our special commentator, Miss Universe 1989, Angela Visser.
Yeah, she's beautiful and a nice lady. You may applaud her, of course.
Yeah, we like Angela.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure the two of you are going to have all the backstage goings-on, all the excitement up there.
Yes, some entertaining stories, Bob. Yeah, we'll be talking about you.
Oh, behind my back. Thanks. We're going to have some entertaining stuff going on here, too, because a little bit later on in the show, you're going to be treated to this sensational voice of Grammy winner Peebo Bryson.
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
I saw it in rehearsal, and we are talking a fantastic number. What a voice.
Yeah, and we're going to be showing you some of the scenic beauty of the Philippines, too, like the magnificent rice terraces of Banaway were behind us here. Yeah.
More on that later.
Very proud of that. Well, right now, it's time for us to get ready for tonight's competition, so let's do that.
All right, let's tell everyone how this works. Now, during the past week, our contestants completed a round of preliminary competition.
And during the preliminaries, the judges scored the contestants in three events, which weigh equally in selecting the 10 semifinalists.
The swimsuit competition, in which they modeled identical suits.
The evening gown competition, with the ladies wearing gowns which they chose themselves.
And the interview competition, where each judge spoke individually with each contestant.
Now, the scores from these three events have been added and averaged for the contestants' preliminary rankings.
That's right, and you'll see those scores in just a moment as we begin our traditional parade of nations.
Ooh, I think I hear a parade coming now. He overacted.
Yeah, well, since you're hearing things, I am going to leave now.
Okay, before I overact again.
Yeah,
thanks
I'm
a lot. Arthel Neville, everybody.
Good luck, ladies. I'll see you later. Good luck.
And now, as our delegates introduce themselves, you will see how each young lady looked in the preliminaries and the score that she received. Ladies and gentlemen, here are the 77 contestants for the title of Miss Universe 1994 in the Parade of Nations. First, the contestants from the island. Beginning with Guam.
Today from the friendly island Guam, where America's Day begins, Paris.
Northern Marianas.
Happy day from the 14 islands of the Northern Marianas. I am Elizabeth McCanny.
Aruba.
Buen día, I'm Alexandra Ochoa, representing the one happy island, Aruba.
The Dominican Republic.
La Vega Valley is my home. I'm Bielka Valenzuela from the Dominican Republic.
Trinidad Tobago.
I'm Lorca Gatlip from the land of Calypso. Trinidad and Tobago!
Puerto Rico!
Hola, I'm Brenda Robles, and I represent the Pride of the Caribbean. ¡Que viva Puerto Rico!
The Cook Islands!
Good honor from the Cook Islands, a special place and special people. I am Leilani Brown.
Curacao!
Kumbay, my name is Yasmin Clifton, and I come from Willemstad, Curacao.
Turks and Caicos!
Hello, greetings from the Caribbean. My name is Julie Swalken and I represent the lovely Turks and Caicos Islands.
The Cayman Islands.
Greetings from the diverse paradise, the Cayman Islands. My name is Audrey Banks.
The British Virgin Islands.
Hi, I'm Julia John Baptiste, representing Nations of the Secret, the British Virgin Islands.
The Bahamas.
So many islands, so many smiles. My name is Mika Knowles, representing the Bahamas.
Mauritius.
Bonsoir, Babaji, and I represent the island nation of Mauritius.
And Jamaica.
Hello, I'm Anthony Martin, representing the exciting island of reggae, Jamaica.
And now the delegates from Central and North America. Beginning with Costa Rica.
Hola, my name is Yasmin Morales, and I come from the natural paradise of Costa Rica.
The USA.
Celebrating the 25th anniversary of the moonwalk, I'm Lou Parker from the USA.
Guatemala.
Buenas noches from Guatemala, the land of eternal spring. I'm Katia Schoenstedt.
Panama.
Hola, I am Maria Sofia Velazquez from Panama.
El Salvador.
Buenas noches, the country of smiles is my home. From El Salvador, I am Claudia Mendez.
Honduras.
Hi, I'm Jim Haylock from the Paradise Island of Guanaja, Honduras.
Canada.
Hello, my name is Suzanne Rafos, and I'm proud to represent a country of many nations, Canada.
And Mexico.
Hola, I'm Fabiola Perez Ovirosa. Arriba Chihuahua, viva Mexico.
Next, the contestants from Europe and the British Isles. Starting with Norway.
God kveld, I'm Carolina Sater from the home of the Olympics, Norway.
Switzerland.
Gretti, my name is Patricia Fessler and I come from the paradise of Europe, Switzerland.
Portugal.
Hola, I am Monica Pereira from the European capital of culture, Portugal.
Sweden.
I'm Dominique Forsberg from the land of the midnight sun, Kiruna, Lapland, Sweden.
The Slovak Republic.
Priyami, dobry večer.
večer. I'm Silvia Lakatošová and I come from a new Slovak Republic.
Great Britain!
Hello, I'm Michaela Pike from the historic Kent district of Great Britain.
Denmark!
Well, my name is Dita Anderson and I come from the land of the Little Mermaid, Denmark.
Ireland!
This is Margaret from Ireland, the land of saints and scholars. My name is Pamela Flood.
Luxembourg!
Hello, I'm Sandy Wagner. I'm from the land of banks, Luxembourg.
France.
Bonsoir, my name is Valérie Kless. I come from the Loire Valley of France.
Estonia.
Greetings and hello. My name is Eva Maria Lahn and I represent the Baltic country of Estonia.
Belgium.
Wow, my name is Christelle and I come from the capital of the common market, Belgium.
Germany.
Vietnam. I'm Germany, the land of hearts and magic. I am Tanya Bill.
Poland!
Witam wszystkich, my name is Joanna Brychczyńska, I'm from the land of Chopin, Poland!
Hungary!
Üdvözlöm Önöket, my name is Silvia Furian, land of the Blue Danube, Hungary!
Finland!
I come from land of Santa Claus, I'm Henna Merilainen of Finland!
Iceland!
Hello, my name is Vala Björkarnadóttir and I'm representing Iceland!
Bulgaria!
I'm Nathan Marino from the country of the Black Sea, Bulgaria!
Romania!
Bună seara, from Friendly Bucharest, I'm Mihaela Ciolacu representing Romania!
Russia!
Hi, I'm Ines Zobba and presenting here the land of strong people, Russia!
And the Netherlands!
Hi, from Leiden, the Netherlands, the land of the windmills, my name is Irene from the lab!
Now let's meet the ladies from the Mediterranean, the Middle East, and Africa! Starting with Italy!
Buonasera from Roma, the Eternal City of Italy. I'm Arianna David.
Spain.
Hola, I'm from España, the land of flamenco. I am Raquel Rodriguez. Olé.
The Republic of Malta.
Good evening, I'm Paola Camilleri from the Mediterranean paradise island of Malta.
Cyprus.
Yes, my name is Maria Vasiliou and I come from the island of love and beauty, Cyprus.
Turkey.
Merhaba, from Turkey, the bridge to Europe and Asia. I am Manu Slag.
Swaziland.
Sabona, I am Nicholas Smith representing the mountain kingdom of Swaziland.
Israel.
Well, I'm from Israel, the land of sand and holy places. My name is Original Kani.
Greece.
Yes, I'm Reda Tunzi representing the home of the ancient gods, Greece.
Nigeria.
I'm Susan Hart and I'm representing the Giants of Africa, Nigeria!
Namibia!
My name is Barbara Kachikara, I represent the Smile of Africa, Namibia!
Zimbabwe!
Hello, I'm Yvette Salmeida Chakras from the home of Victoria Falls, Zimbabwe!
And Egypt!
Good evening, I'm Radan Salem from the land of pharaohs, Cairo, Egypt!
Here are the senoritas from South America! Starting with Uruguay.
Buenas noches, mi nombre es Leonora Di Bueno. I come from Montevideo, Uruguay.
Paraguay.
Hola, I'm Liliana González from the land of Nenutí, Asunción, Paraguay.
Chile.
Hola, I represent Chile, the land of los Andes. I am Constanza Barbieri.
Peru.
Hola, I am Karina Calmet from the land of Incas, Lima, Perú.
Colombia.
Hola, I'm Carolina Gómez Correa. I come from the land of passions and emeralds, Colombia.
Ecuador.
Hola, from Galapagos Island Country, Ecuador. I am Mafalda Arboleda.
Bolivia.
Hola, I am Cecilia Cornut from the heart of South America, Tarija, Bolivia.
Brazil.
I'm Valeria Pérez from Brazil, the land of the samba.
Argentina.
Hola, I'm Solan Mañano from land of the Pampa, Santa Fe, Argentina.
And Venezuela.
Hola, amigos del universo. My name is Minorca Mercado y I'm from Caracas, Venezuela.
And now the delegates from Asia and the lands down under.
Hi, it's fun here. Hello, everyone here.
Starting with Thailand.
Swadika, representing the Kingdom of Thailand, I'm Aria Chumthai.
Australia.
Australia, the largest island and smallest continent. I am Michelle Van Imeren.
Hong Kong.
Dagaho, my name is Hoyamo. I come from the Pearl of the East, Hong Kong.
New Zealand.
Bureau from Queensbury, New Zealand. My name is Nicola Brady.
Taiwan, the Republic of China.
您好 ，Hello, I'm Zhong Junwu. I come from Taiwan, of the Republic of China.
Singapore.
Hi, I'm Holly Sun from the sunny island city of Singapore.
Korea.
안녕하세요, I'm Kung Sun Young from Land of the Morning Come, Korea.
Japan.
Yes, I'm Obama from the tranquil Shikoku Island of Japan. I'm Jackie Kawahito.
Malaysia.
Selamat sejahtera, my name is Lisa Koh. I come from the land of the hornbill birds, Malaysia.
India.
Namaste, I'm Sushmita Sen from a country where love is the essence of life. India.
Sri Lanka.
Hi everyone, I'm the star Fernando proudly representing the pearl of the Indian Ocean, Sri Lanka.
And the Philippines.
Mabuhay and welcome to my country. I'm Charlene Bonin Gonzalez from the Philippines.
Payless Shoe Source is a proud sponsor of the 1994 Miss Universe pageant. At Payless, you get all the latest looks and shoes at unbelievably low prices. Doesn't it feel good to pay less?
And welcome back to our live show from Manila and our anchor booth here in the Philippine International Convention Center. And I am happy to have as my partner here tonight, Miss Universe 1989, Holland's very own Angela Visser. Nice to see you.
Thank you. Hello, everyone.
And I have been seeing you everywhere. What, 90210, Blossom?
Yeah, it's been going great, having a good time. And congratulations, you have a new show coming up.
Yes, thank you. We have a new name. It's called Extra, the entertainment magazine. Due out this fall.
Well, good luck with it.
Thank you. Now, I know what, this is your fourth year as special commentator, and you've been here several weeks getting to know the girls, interviewing everyone.
Right.
So I have to ask you, who are your favorites?
Well, Miss Belgium, ever since this girl arrived, she's been a crowd favorite. I tell you, her pictures have been everywhere, across the press. She gets tons of fan mail every day, so we should look out for her. And Miss Venezuela, pretty hard to miss.
Yeah.
Miss Australia, she's a wonderful girl. And of course, my sentimental favorite, Miss Netherlands.
I understand that. I understand that. By the way, the contestants can't hear what Angela and I are saying up here. We don't want to distract them from the competition.
That's right. And the judges can't hear us either, so we won't influence the scoring.
Well, Angela, what everyone back home wants to know is how will Miss USA Lou Parker do?
Well, I love Lou. This girl, she's bright, she's outgoing, she's tons of fun, and she puts people right at ease. So with those qualities, I think she could be a great Miss Universe.
Yeah, and I think she can make it Miss Universe as well, not just because she's Miss USA. Okay, well, I see that Bob is ready on stage, so let's find out who the semifinalists really are.
All right, everybody, the moment has come to reveal the names of our 10 semifinalists, the ladies who will continue in tonight's competition. Now, as each semifinalist comes forward, you will see her composite preliminary score on the screen. Ladies, are you ready? All right, I'm going to read these names in random order. The first semifinalist is Miss India Sushmita Sen.
To prepare, Sushmita studied tapes of previous pageants with two former Miss Indias.
Well, I'd say that homework has paid off.
Miss Venezuela Menorca Mercado.
You called it, Angela. Venezuela's in.
Oh, believe me, this was an easy pick. Menorca's been a favorite from the very beginning.
Miss Greece Rhea Tutunzi.
You know, Arthel, there were over 400 entries in the Miss Greece pageant, and Rhea won.
She's got a real fresh, young look, right?
Yeah, I think she's
it. Miss Switzerland, Patricia Fessler.
She's a 19-year-old university student who, believe it or not, once swam with 500 penguins in the Indian Ocean.
Well, the final question to her ought to be,
Miss USA, Lou Parker.
The USA hasn't won since 1980.
And the last winner from the USA was Sean Weatherly from Lou's home state.
All right, that's half the spots filled. The number six position goes to Miss Italy, Arianna David.
Ariana's a student in Rome.
And she's also modeled for some of Italy's top designers. Wait until you see her evening gown.
And we have another spot waiting for Miss Sweden, Dominique Forsberg.
You thought Dominique would do well.
Yes, I did. She has classic good looks and she's a real natural beauty. She was bound to stand out.
Miss Slovak Republic, Silvia Lagunchova.
Now, this is the first contestant ever from the Slovak Republic, and you think Silvia could take it all, don't you?
Yeah, I do. Just look at that elegance.
Miss Philippines, Charlene Gonzalez.
I knew the crowd would go crazy for Charlene Gonzalez.
Well, as you can hear, they take their pageants very seriously here in the Philippines.
Only one spot remaining, one final chance to become Miss Universe 1994, and it belongs to Miss Colombia, Carolina Gomez.
Carolina really knows how to charm an audience, doesn't she?
Well, I'll say she's definitely someone to keep an eye on tonight.
Well, there they are, ladies and gentlemen, the 10 semifinalists for the title of Miss Universe 1994.
Well, there they are, 10 sensational ladies, and if the applause doesn't tell you how much they love pageants here, check out this new stamp issue, hot off the press.
Yes, the Philippines' two Miss Universe winners from 1969 and 1973.
And you know they're working on our stamps now.
Right.
At this point, all the preliminary scores you just saw are eliminated, and the semifinalists begin competing again, first in swimsuits. And Angela, we saw the preliminary swimsuit competition Sunday night, so who do you think will do well here?
Well, Lou, Miss USA, she has such an interesting way to get in shape. You know, she's a teacher, and she takes her students' papers to the gym and grades them as she's riding the stationary bike.
Yeah, well, I hope she has a good day at the gym, because a bad day could mean a bad grade.
And I think this will be a real moment of triumph for Charlene Gonzalez, Miss Philippines, because when she was growing up as a kid, believe it or not, she was 5'4", and she weighed 167 pounds. And her brother even nicknamed her Miss Piggy.
What? Well, yes. Guess what? I saw her at the preliminaries, and no one's going to call her Miss Piggy tonight.
No
believe
way.
Me. Okay, when we come back, we will meet our celebrity judges and see the swimsuit competition.
Swimsuits next on CBS!
Our thanks to the wonderful Bayanihan dancers. Welcome back to the Philippines, everybody, as we continue our live show from Manila. It's time now to introduce you to our distinguished panel of judges and audience. If you would, please hold your applause until the final judge is introduced. Our first judge is a successful fashion designer from Colombia. His international clients include first ladies, European nobility, artists, and celebrities, Carlos Arturo Zapata. She's a six-time Grammy-winning star and lead singer of The Fifth Dimension, the beautiful, talented singer and actress, Florence LaRue. He was hairdresser to Princess Diana for 9 years and is the international creative director of Clairol, Scotsman Richard Dalton. One of Hollywood's leading character actresses, she appeared in the film MacArthur and is currently in the feature film Bad Girls, Emmy winner Beulah Kuo. He's a philanthropist and humanitarian and chairman of the board of the Philippines' leading newspaper, the Manila Bulletin, Dr. Emilio T. Yap. A British actress best known for her starring roles in Dynasty, The Colbys, Sequest, and Beverly Hills 90210, Stephanie Beecham. He's an award-winning writer-producer working on films for director Richard Donner, Robert De Niro, Whoopi Goldberg, and Steven Spielberg, Jonas McCord. And she was crowned Miss Universe in 1990, lives in the USA, and travels all over the world as a successful fashion model, Norway's Mona Groot. Ladies and gentlemen, our judges.
Judges use a scoring system similar to the Olympics. As each contestant competes, each judge enters a score ranging from 1.0 to a high of 9.99 into a computer terminal. You will see the judges' names and scores on your screen. Then the highest and lowest scores are eliminated and the rest are averaged, like this. Finally, each contestant's average scores in the swimsuit, interview, and evening gown competitions are added, and the top six composite scores will determine
the 6 finalists.
Well, I see the competition is about to begin, so let's go back to Bob on stage.
Okay, thanks a lot, Angela. Well, now as our contestants compete in the Janssen swimsuit competition, they're going to be wearing shoes by Federico Leone, and we have asked each woman to tell us a bit more about herself. The crater of an extinct volcano is the exotic locale of beautiful Hidden Valley Falls and the perfect setting for the swimsuit competition as we begin with Miss India.
I'm passionate about writing poetry. Yeah, I'm not very expressive with people, and sometimes I find it easier to put down my thoughts and my emotions on a piece of paper.
Miss Venezuela.
Definitely more than anything else, I have to say I'm very disciplined. I get that from my parents. Also, I love a challenge. The bigger, the better.
Miss Greece.
I've been modeling for less than a year now. And on my first runway show, I was really scared. It was an experience I'll never forget. But once I was up there, I really knew I belonged there.
Miss Switzerland.
Well, in 10 years, I hope to have my own medical practice and a nice man. But no, I think 10 years, that's too soon.
Miss USA.
Well, you know, I'm a teacher. I miss the kids. I miss the energy and the enthusiasm that they give me. And I know they're rooting for me back in South Carolina, but I miss hugging them and I miss touching them.
Miss Italy.
Well, I've watched the Miss Italy pageant on television since I was a little girl. I'd line up my dolls and pretend they were the contestants. Who could have dreamed back then that I'd grow up to be here tonight? I thought things like this only happened in fantasy.
Miss Sweden.
I think Swedish people are very genuine and honest. Very much down to earth and in touch with nature. They're a little bit quiet in the beginning, just like myself, until they get to know you. And then we become friends for life.
Miss Slovak Republic.
I'm a kind of person that I must be every time busy. I can't sit, I must go, 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 and that makes me very happy.
Miss Philippines.
Well, the person I most admire is my stepfather. He's always been there for me and been a friend. And he's not my biological father, but yet he loves me like his own flesh and blood. And I love him for that.
Miss Colombia.
Well, I've always wanted to help people. Now, as a Miss Colombia, I travel around my country doing charity work. And I especially enjoy working with unwed teenage mothers because as a teenager, I want them to know that I care.
And that completes the swimsuit competition for Miss Universe 1994.
at the picture, it isn't just women in the USA who are into fitness. Everybody's doing it.
Right, we've been working out here every night.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right. Well, let's see how our judges scored it. Okay, Miss Venezuela tops the swimsuit competition with a 9.7, followed closely by Miss India and Miss Colombia. Miss USA, she's going to make it up there in the top three pretty soon, I'm sure.
And Jensen will award the winner, Miss Venezuela, a $1,000 prize.
Sushi money, huh?
Right.
Okay, the ladies are heading backstage to change for the interview competition, so this is the perfect moment to take you on a little tour of the Philippines and see what they've been doing for the past few weeks. Let's go.
Some fun.
Thank you very much.
Manila, see you in Manila.
Oh no!
There's a lot to learn.
This is Dr. Jose Rizal, our national hero. So did you have fun here at Rizal Park?
Yeah!
Okay, let's go, girls.
Manila.
Manila, I keep coming back to Manila. Manila, I'm coming home.
We took a jeepney ride from Manila to Villa Escudero, where we cooked lunch in a very unusual setting.
We're off to Davao on the Isle of Mindanao.
That drink will make you fall in love with the next man you see.
Yeah! All aboard for the Pearl Fund!
Oh,
ladies, our hostess, Miss Universe 1973, Margarita Moran.
Welcome to the Pearl Farm Beach Resort. Mabuhay!
Next stop, Cebu, Queen City of the South. Ladies, historic Fort San Pedro.
Built by the Spanish in 1738.
Who's conducting the tour anyway? Try the green mango.
Delicious.
Ladies, hurry!
Interview competition is coming up next, so who's going to do well here?
Arthel, I cannot wait for Miss Slovak Republic, Sylvia. This girl is incredible. Listen, she has modeled everywhere. She has published a book. She owns her own PR firm, and on top of it all, she's working on her own clothing line.
What? So when does she sleep?
I have no idea. Gosh. And oh, Miss Columbia, she's such a free spirit. You know, she once underwent hypnotic past life regression.
Okay, that's where you go back to another life and figure out what you were, like a tree or a car or something.
Right.
Yeah, oh, okay. Well, some lively conversation, maybe even a little reincarnation, right after this.
We are back, and we're coming to you live from Manila, and we'd like to take this moment to thank the people of the Philippines for their terrific hospitality, and we are very honored to have with us this evening His Excellency, the President of the Republic of the Philippines, Fidel V. Ramos, and First Lady Amelita Ramos. Thank you for having us. It's also our pleasure to announce that the Miss Universe pageant is going to travel to the African continent for the first time when we broadcast live from the nation of Namibia next year. And here this evening as representatives of Namibia's host committee are Peter Manser and Miss Universe 1992, Namibia's own Michelle McLean. And we are also very pleased to announce that next year in Namibia, we will welcome our first delegate from the Republic of South Africa since 1984. Well, now I have the pleasure of talking individually with our 10 semifinalists in the interview competition. And because our title holders' communication skills are so important, our interviews are spontaneous, they're unrehearsed, and the ladies are judged on their poise, their intelligence, their personality, and of course the content of their answers. Now, for those contestants who have requested them, we have De La Vega Professional Translating Services standing by, and we begin with Miss India, Sushmita Sen. She's an 18-year-old model from New Delhi who enjoys writing poetry in her spare time. Now, I heard you say earlier during the Parade of Nations that your country, in your country, love is the essence of life. What did you mean by that?
Well, India is a country that everybody knows has multinational people, as in people with different languages, people with different religions. And we have about 168 languages, and people all live together. And there is, to quite an extent, a lot of peace, which is very difficult with so many religions staying together. And that is why I said love is the essence of life in India. Thank you.
Now, you have got to be a very, very public figure in India, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, but you also describe yourself as a private person. Now, how do you get the two working together?
Well, I think every human being must have two faces. It's very essential. One which you have for people in public and one which you have for yourself. Because these two different things, when mixed together, makes you a person who has just a personality which is fit for everybody else but not for one's own self. And I think it's very essential that you have a private side to yourself. I have it too.
All right, that's Sushmita Sen, Miss India. Thank you very much. And if you just step right over here, please. Right over there. Next up, we have Miss Venezuela. She's 22-year-old Menorca Mercado of Caracas, a university student and member of the Venezuelan national volleyball team. So clearly you are a serious athlete. How has sports shaped your life?
¿Cómo que los deportes han forjado tu vida?
De una manera muy positiva, me han ayudado a que la mujer tiene que ser trabajadora, luchadora. Me han despertado ese deseo de superación, de que hay que luchar por esos principios morales que nuestra familia nos inculcan desde pequeño.
In a very positive way, sports have taught me that a woman must work hard and she must overcome and be a struggler, a fighter. And it has also taught me that I must follow the moral values that my family has taught me since I was a youngster.
Now, being part of this volleyball team is kind of a legacy for your family, isn't it?
El formar parte del equipo de voleibol es como parte de la herencia de tu familia, ¿no es así?
Efectivamente, toda mi familia es deportista. Mi mamá, en sus años de juventud, fue preseleccionada para la selección nacional de vole. Y bueno, ahora el sueño se hizo realidad cuando yo integro la selección nacional de vole.
Yes, as a matter of fact, my whole family participates in sports. My mother, when she was younger, she was pre-selected for the Venezuela national volleyball team, and now I fulfill that because I am part of the national Venezuelan volleyball team.
All right, thank you very much, Miss Venezuela. That is Menorca Mercado. Now we have Miss Greece, Ria Totunzi. She's a 20-year-old from Athens who speaks three languages and enjoys ballet and modeling. What attracted you to modeling?
I really like the glamour of it, and I've felt that I should have been a model since I was really young. It's just that I really, it's just there for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, just a spotlight.
What's the best thing about it? Just being the glamour?
The glamour, and that you're on stage and people expect something from you. You know, and you have to show yourself, right. And what you're wearing is just wonderful for me.
Right, so you feel pretty comfortable up here in front of all these people.
Not quite. This is different. I'm getting judged here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's okay, though.
It's not the same.
Yeah, well, that's okay. But you speak three languages, right? Where did you learn to speak English so well?
I learned it in school, back in Athens.
Uh-huh. Have you ever had much association with Americans?
Yes, I did. I did. There was the American base in Athens. And most of my friends were Americans. And I've been to an English-speaking school for a while, and that's how I picked up the language. My dad is also Lebanese, so he doesn't speak the language, my language, Greek.
Right.
So.
Okay, great. Nice job. Thank you very much, Miss Greece. That's Ria Totunzi. You can step right over there so the judges can take a look at you. Now, Miss Switzerland. This is Patricia Fassler. She's born in Zurich, a 19-year-old university student majoring in languages. What do you hope to do when you complete your education?
When I finish with my education, I want to study medicine, and I want to become a pediatrician.
Really? Yeah. You want to work with kids, huh?
Yes, I want to, because I love children, and I think children are our future.
Now, I also heard that you either did or want to climb the Matterhorn. Is that right?
Yes, it was an idea because in Switzerland, the Matterhorn is one of the biggest mountains, and it's very difficult to climb up to the mountain. So I said, Patricia, you go there and you climb up the mountain, you just try it, and because it's a wonderful feeling if you're on the top of the mountain and you can see all over Switzerland. It's very nice. It's a wonderful view.
So are you an avid mountain climber, or this is just the one thing you want to do?
Yes, it's one thing that is here and here, and I just want to try.
All right, well, we wish you luck on that climb. Good luck to you, Miss Switzerland. That is Patricia Fassler. Step right over there, please. And finally, Miss USA, Lou Parker. She's a 26-year-old high school teacher from Charleston, South Carolina. Hi, Lou. And the founder of a new program called HATS, which stands for Helping All Teens Survive.
Yes.
Tell me about that program.
Well, HATS is very important to me. I'm an educator, and I started HATS, Helping All Teens Survive, because of some unfortunate suicides and pregnancies. But it's a peer outreach program that takes care of teens that are in need.
And did I hear that they're going to open a chapter here in Manila?
Actually, yes, I was interviewing with the Herald Tribune, and this gentleman interviewed me for like 20 minutes or so, and then he said, you know, I'm really interested in your program, and I about lost it at that moment, because it would be my first international affiliate, but I have them in the States, in about five states, but not anywhere internationally, so I was very excited.
Wow, that's great. Now, if you should come here and open a chapter, you're going to have to learn a little bit of the native language, right? Yeah.
Well, actually, I've been here so long, I feel like a local. You know, I'm learning the language a little bit.
Tagalog?
You know?
Can you speak some?
A little bit.
Go ahead. Give me a shot.
Do you want me to say it to the audience or to you?
Yeah. Should you say it to you?
Okay. Hello, if I came back. Magandang umaga, sanyong lahat. Nag-enjoya ko. Salamat pa. Salamat po. Sanyong lahat. Mahakita.
You must have done something right. What'd you say?
I said, good morning to all of you. I've enjoyed my stay. Thank you to all of you, and I love you.
Okay, that's Lou Parker, Miss USA. Go on right over there if you would, Lou. All right, thanks a lot, ladies. That completes our first five interviews.
Yes, and Luis Magumbahat, which means she's very beautiful. Well, a pretty impressive group, I'll say. Stay with us, and we'll be back in a moment after this word from Badal Sassoon Hair Care System for hair with salon feeling every day.
We're continuing live from the Philippines now with more of the interview competition, and our next contestant is Miss Italy, Arianna David. She's a 20-year-old model and art history student from Rome. Welcome. And what do you hope to do when you complete your studies?
Che cosa vuoi fare dopo terminare gli studi?
Dunque, io vorrei insegnare perché mi piace stare a contatto con i ragazzi, oppure stare a contatto sempre con le persone e facendo la direttrice turistica, cioè andando in giro con... Oddio, scusate, mi sono un pochino emozionata. Praticamente descrivere le chiese con delle persone che ascoltano, ecco.
Well, when I finish my studies, I'd like, there are two things that I'm interested in. One is to teach. I like to be with children, and I might possibly do that. Another possibility is that as I'm interested in art, I may want to be a guide or in touch with people who are interested in knowing what our monuments, our churches are. Excuse me because I'm a little bit emotional right now, but this is what I'm trying to convey to you.
That's all right. Have you ever been to the United States?
Tu sei mai stata negli Stati Uniti?
No, non sono mai stata negli Stati Uniti. Vedo ogni giovedì sera Beverly Hills in televisione. Chissà.
I think I got some of that.
No, I have never been to the United States, but I see the United States every Thursday night on television.
All right, that's Miss Italy, Arianna David. Thank you very much. Step right over there. Next up, we have Miss Sweden, Dominique Forsberg. She's 25 years old, speaks five languages, and has done a lot of public relations work for her native Lapland. Now, pardon my ignorance, but is Lapland like a state or a province or what?
It's a region in the northern part of Sweden. It's called a landscape.
Now, what would I see if I went there?
Well, what we have is called the last wilderness of Europe, and just a big, vast wilderness with lots of adventures. And what I think is the most amazing thing is maybe the midnight sun in the summer, because it's 24-hour sunshine, and it can be very romantic. But then in the winter, there's another phenomena, the northern lights. And even though I live there myself, I never stop being amazed by this. It's magic.
Yeah. Now, yes. It's cold, isn't it?
Oh, yes, very, very cold. I love the weather here. It's so nice for change.
But I hear the fishing is terrific.
Yes, great fishing. And in the summer you can fish 24 hours because it's sunshine.
Sunshine all day?
Yeah.
Wow. Perfect for the fishermen in the family.
Yeah.
All right, Miss Sweden, thank you very much. That's Dominique Forsberg. Can you step over there, please? Now we have Miss Slovak Republic, Silvia Lakatushova, a 21-year-old entrepreneur who speaks Italian, Russian, Slovak, Czech, and luckily for me, a little bit of English, too. Look at this. You have already modeled, you've published a book, you co-own a PR firm, and you're only 21 years old. What's left for you to do?
You know, after when I come back home, after this competition, after 3 weeks, I have examined for my new university because I want to study lawyer. I want to be lawyer. And after, maybe after 5 years, I will be a good lawyer because, you know, now in my country is a new situation, economic and politic. And a good lawyer is, I think, in every country very important. And I want to be a good lawyer.
Okay. Well, you brought it up. There's a different situation in your country. You're 21, so you were about 16 when communism fell. Were you active in the revolution, and what was all that like?
Yes, of course. You know, for us, for children, for students, it was something new because we are waiting for something new, and we go on the place where the manifestation, and we with the key like, oh, we want the new politics, man, and we want change our life, we want something new, and everybody's on the street was like friends, and we feel like one family. It was so great time.
Very happy time, I'm sure. Okay, yeah. Miss Slovak Republic, thank you very much. You step over there, Silvia Lakatushova. Mm-hmm. Now we have Miss Philippines, Charlene Bonan Gonzalez, a university student from Manila, who turned 20 while you were here at the pageant. Happy birthday to you, first of all.
Thank you so much.
Now, being in pageants is kind of a legacy for you, too, right?
Well, not necessarily. This is my first pageant prior to the local pageant.
But what I mean is it's happened in your family before.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. My mom was first runner-up in the Miss Philippines, so I'm kind of carrying on this opportunity for her.
Mm-hmm. Now, she sort of parlayed that first runner-up in the Philippines into an acting career. Is that what you plan on doing?
Well, actually, I'm part-time acting right now, but it's just so I could put my foot in the water and try different fields of my life.
Mm-hmm. Is that what you want to end up doing, though, you think?
Eventually, I want to pursue my career and become a doctor and eventually a surgeon. That's my biggest dream in my life.
Okay. Now, we have been videotaping all over this country, and if there is one thing that I have learned, you guys have a bunch of islands here. How many islands are in the Philippines?
High tide or low tide?
Give them both.
Well, with high tide, we have 7,107, and then low tide, we have 7,108.
Wow, amazing. All right. Well, on behalf of the staff here in the Miss Universe pageant, we'd like to thank you and all your countrymen. You've been very gracious, very hospitable, and we thank you for having us here in the Philippines. That's Miss Philippines, Charlene Bonan Gonzalez. And our final interview goes to Miss Colombia, 19-year-old Carolina Gomez of Bogota. She is one of six children. She enjoys writing short stories and is fluent in both Spanish and English. Now, I know in Colombia you do a lot of charity work, is that right?
Yes, as a Miss Colombia, I have to work mm-hmm. and tour around my country, raising funds for charitable institutions.
And one of the things that you specialize in, or at least emphasize, is with pregnant, unwed teenagers. Is that right?
Yes, I work with unwed teenage mothers, actually. I think that as a teenager, I want them to know that I care, and I do hope to be able to help them. And not only that, but I think we have to educate these girls, because it's not a matter of only helping them and letting them know, yes, I'm here for you, but, you know, I'm not trying to encourage them to have more and more babies without being married. But I think that the family is like the basic important thing in society. So I think that we have to help get this together.
Is that how we curb the problem, do you think, with education?
Yes, of course. Of course, definitely.
All right. Miss Colombia, thank you very much.
Thanks.
That's Carolina Gomez. Thanks to all 10 of our ladies. That completes our semifinal interview competition for Miss Universe 1994.
Okay, let's see how the judges scored this competition. Aha, Miss Slovak Republic, not surprised there. What a cute answer. And Miss Colombia and Venezuela still up in the top three. Both of those ladies were in the top three in the swimsuit competition, you may remember. Now that completes two-thirds of the semifinals, and the evening gown competition will be coming up soon.
And the delegates are backstage right now, changing into their costumes for a great musical number with Peebo Bryson.
It's going to be good, so stay with us and you'll see it coming up next.
Welcome back as we continue our live show from Manila, and now serenading the delegates and the reigning Miss Universe, Dayanara Torres, with his hit from the motion picture Aladdin. Please welcome the great Peebo Bryson.
I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over sideways and under, on a magic carpet ride, a whole new way. A new fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
A whole new world.
just terrific. Phoebo, great, great job. Just great. Dianar, ladies, that was just sensational. Weren't they terrific?
Absolutely.
Very nice. Well, while our contestants are getting ready for the evening gown competition, here are Arthel and Angela with a look at some of the other competitions that have been going on over the past few weeks.
Part of the fun of the pageant is filling the scrapbook with photos, and all the contestants participate in the Minolta Photo Contest. The winner this year was Miss Denmark Gita Andersen with her snap of Miss Israel. Her prize is a Minolta autofocus camera.
And this year, Minolta is also giving a $1,000 award to the contestant named Miss Photogenic. And for 1994, it's the beautiful Minorca Mercado, Miss Venezuela.
Okay, the real glamour event is next. Angela, who do you think's going to do well in the evening gown competition?
Italy!
I know, I mean, her gown is like nothing I've seen before at a pageant. It's beautiful.
I know it is, and in it she creates such a, like, an air of mystery, and, well, I'm not going to give it all away, but it's very haute couture, very European, and very daring.
Ooh. Well, now you won't want to miss that, so don't go away. It'll be magic in Manila when we return.
Back to our live show from Manila, everybody. It has long been a tradition of the Miss Universe pageant to choose little girls from the countries that we visit to serve as little sisters to our contestants. Now get ready to have your heart melted. Meet the little sisters of the Philippines as they set the mood for our evening gown competition. Beginning with Miss India.
Shine through, because you are.
Republic. Colombia. Concludes our evening gown competition and our semifinals. Thank you, ladies, and thank you, little sisters.
Oh, those little girls are gonna make me cry. I want one of those. Well, okay, let's see how the judges score this last semifinal event. Aha, Miss Colombia tops the evening gown competition, not surprised, with a 9.89, followed by Miss Venezuela, who again was in the top three in swimsuit and interview competition, followed by Miss India with a 9.792. Now remember, these scores are now added to those from the swimsuit and interview competition and averaged to determine the six finalists, and we will find out who they are when we come back.
Welcome back to the Philippines, everyone, where we are coming to you live. And now, as our delegates join us, we have come to the next turning point in the evening. Here are the names of the six ladies whom the judges have chosen to continue as finalists. Again, ladies, I am going to read these names in random order. Good luck to all of you. The first finalist is Miss Colombia, Carolina Gomez. Miss Slovak Republic, Silvia Lagrasova. Miss Philippines, Charlie Bonin Gonzalez. Only three spots remain, and one of those spots belongs to Miss India, Sushmita Sen. And another belongs to Miss Venezuela, Menorca Mercado. Well, only one woman has the chance to go on to become Miss Universe of the remaining five, and that woman is Miss USA, Lou Parker. The six finalists for the title of Miss Universe 1994.
Six very happy but nervous. famous ladies. Now, the judges' questions are coming up in a few moments, so while the six finalists are backstage getting even more nervous, why don't we take a closer look at this fascinating country? Here's the reigning Miss Universe, Dayanara Torres, to show us around the Philippines.
Philippines, where the influence of Asia, Europe, and America combine in a culture that is both ancient and modern, but always Filipino.
Magellan sailed to the Philippines in 1521 and claimed these islands for Spain.
That began 377 years of Spanish colonial rule, echoed here in the capital city of Manila.
The conquistadors named the islands in honor of King Philip and converted the people to Catholicism. To this day, the Philippines is the only predominantly Christian country in Asia.
The Philippine alliance with the United States was never stronger than the World War II, when General Douglas MacArthur established his command post here at the elegant Manila Hotel.
At Corregidor Island, these ruins, which still stand, attest to the fierce battles that took place here. The Pacific War Memorial commemorates the thousands of men and women who lost their lives here.
The Philippines gained full independence in 1946, and today is one of the most democratic countries in Asia.
Manila's historical Malacañã Palace has been home to many of the nation's governors and presidents, including the incumbent president Fidel Ramos. Manila is one of the world's megacities and home to nearly 10 million people. It's the center of commerce, entertainment, culture, with beautiful paintings, sculptures, and handicraft, and of course, fun and relaxation.
North of Manila is Subic Bay, once the largest American naval station outside the U.S. It is now a free trade zone and an investment area. Subic is also a fun zone, where you can ride a horse along jungle trails and fascinating things may happen.
Even an encounter with thousands of fruit bats.
Exploring farther north, you will find the magnificent rice terraces of Benawi, sculpted on the sides of mountains.
Farmers plant rice here, in the very same terraces their ancestor, the Ifugao tribe, built over 2,000 years ago. In the countryside, you will find beautiful handicrafts, especially wood carving and weaving.
The most beautiful active volcano is Taal, the volcano within a lake within a volcano within a lake.
This nation is made up of 7,107 islands, with almost that many spectacular beaches, like Palawan, with its sugary white sand.
There is a number of deluxe resorts like Boracay, giving you the choice to be on the water, near the water, or under the water.
So many choices, but one thing is certain, the island Philippines is a tropical paradise of Asia.
Mabuhay y adios.
Thanks a lot, Dayanara. Now, as we mentioned, the judges' questions are coming up next. The final three contestants. And as before, all the previous scores are erased and they begin again on equal footing.
And you will continue to see the judges' individual scores, but no composite score, so that will keep you in suspense.
Remember, only three will survive, so stay with us and see who they are.
We are back and coming to you live from the Philippine International Convention Center in Manila, and we continue our competition now with our judges' questions, which will determine our final three contestants. Now, each finalist is going to draw a judge's name from this bowl, and they'll have to answer a question from that judge. The contestant will have 20 seconds in which to answer, and as they vote, the judges will consider not only the answer, but they will also see a video reminder of that contestant competing earlier, so that their scores will be based on their overall impression of her this evening. And remember, the score from the judge asking the question will be highlighted on your screen. So we begin now with Miss Colombia. Go ahead and select the judge's name. All right, you have gone with judge number 6. Stephanie Beecham.
What do you consider the greatest problem facing young people in the world today?
I think the greatest problem that people are facing, at least young people are facing at this time, is not being very secure of themselves. I think that we have to look up to older people because we think that we know too much. And I think that wisdom is acquired by learning from the people that have lived more years of their life.
All right, that's Miss Columbia.
I wonder what awaits Carolina back home if she wins tonight.
Oh, that's right, because the last Colombian to win Miss Universe was given a mansion and declared tax-exempt for life.
Okay, Carolina, if you would, step back, please. Miss Slovak Republic. Sylvia, take a name. You've chosen judge number four, Beulah Quo.
Do you think a woman is unfulfilled if she does not have children? Why or why not?
You understand?
Yeah.
Tu pensi che la vita di una donna è incompleta se non ha figli? E perché o perché no?
Yeah, I think that I think for me it's a very important the family, and I think also for women the work of woman is that she must have a children, and I think that it's if she has a children and a good man and family, it's for me it will be so great.
All right, Miss Slovak Republic, stay right where you are.
You know, our country is a little more than a year old.
Uh-huh, yet here's Sylvia with a chance to be the next Miss Universe.
Okay, Sylvia, if you would, step back there. And Miss Philippines now. Go ahead, into the bowl. You've chosen judge number seven, Jonas McCord.
If you could be a fictional film or literary character, who would you be and why?
I think I would be Superwoman because she helps a lot of people, she's very fun, and she's a dynamic person who does many deeds for our world.
All right, that's Miss Philippines.
Her mother and brother are actors, so Charlene's used to media exposure.
Well, she'll have plenty of that if she wins tonight.
Okay, Charlene, if you'd step back there, and we bring in Miss India now. Sushmita, if you would grab a name. You have gone with judge number two, Florence LaRue.
Congratulations. If you had the time and money to embark upon a great adventure, what would it be?
Well, I think adventure for me is something that I enjoy from within me. And I think children are the little things that can really bring in a lot of adventure in your life. And if I had the time and the money, and I could do something. I wouldn't say I would do something for the children who are downtrodden. Any child is worth its while. I would do something for the children so I could enjoy my time with them, go out and have a good time. Thank you very much.
All right, Miss India, stay right where you are.
Sushmita's father gave her the nickname Titan because he said he wished for her to get everything she wanted in life.
Bet I know what she's wishing for now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Sushmita, if you'd step back, please, and Miss Venezuela. Manuka Mercado, select the name, please. You have gone with judge number eight, Mona Groot.
What relevance do you think pageants such as this have for women today?
¿Qué importancia crees tú que tienen los certámenes de este tipo para la mujer de hoy en día?
La importancia fundamental es que mediante este certamen podemos transmitir un gran mensaje a toda la humanidad porque actualmente, gracias a la nueva tecnología, nos podemos comunicar, no existen fronteras que nos puedan separar y bueno, y nosotros tenemos que aprovechar esto para unir todos los seres humanos mediante la paz, la unión y la comunicación entre todos los seres humanos y sobre todo el amor que es lo fundamental.
I believe that the basic relevance of all of this is that we have to, through these kind of pageants, take advantage of telecommunications, of what we have at our disposal in order to communicate with all of humanity, in order to transmit a wonderful message of peace and love, in order to bring the whole world together.
All right, that's Ms. Venezuela. Stay right here.
Well, Minorca is a professional athlete who, until a few months ago, believe it or not, didn't even own a pair of high heels.
Well, and here she is with a chance to be the new Miss Universe.
Okay, now you may go, Minorca Mercado, and now Lou Parker, Miss USA. Go ahead. And you have gone with judge number one, Carlos Arturo Zapata.
Thank you. Everyone has a mission in life. What do you think your mission is?
My mission? Well, I'm an educator, and deep in my heart, I think that is what I'm going to work for the rest of my life, be it little kids or older kids. There's so much that is lost. They don't have any family life. They don't have any goals set for themselves, and that's my mission, to go out and make a difference in a child's life, be it one or thousands.
All right, Lou Parker, Miss USA.
Lou has a theory. She thinks to win a pageant, you have to come in believing you're the winner already.
Well, that's how she won USA, and we'll know soon if that theory works again.
All right, thank you very much, Miss USA. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that completes the judges' questions for our six finalists. Thank you, ladies, and thank you very much, judges, as well.
Pretty good answers, I'll say. Well, Angela, yes. They're about to name the final three contestants.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what do you think?
I really don't like this moment very much. How can you pick three out of these six? I go for Lou, Miss USA. She's been my favorite from the beginning. Let's see, Miss Venezuela gave a wonderful answer. And Miss Philippines.
Good choices, Angela, I'll say.
Thank you.
Well, you pick your three, and we'll see who's right when we come back.
We are back with our live show from Manila, and now it is time to find out who the judges selected to be the final three contestants for the title of Miss Universe. Ooh, ladies, you ready? Remember, I'm going to read these names in random order, and good luck to all of you. The first final three is Miss Venezuela, Menorca Mercado. Miss India, Sushmita Sen. And the final woman with a chance to become Miss Universe 1994, she is Miss Colombia, Carolina Gomez. Ladies and gentlemen, one of these three beautiful young women will be the new Miss Universe.
Well, one of your picks made it.
It's just too difficult.
I know. Well, they're coming up to the very last round of competition, the final question.
Yes, and this is really a test of nerve because the judges are considering everything they've done this evening. But if they freeze on this question,
it's all over.
Exactly.
Okay, they're ready on stage, so let's see how they handle it.
A lot of excitement in the room, a lot of excitement in the room, as you can tell, but we now have come to the final question, ladies. This is the last round of competition for the evening. Now, you are going to each get a question, and you will get the same question. You'll have 20 seconds in which to answer that question, and make sure that it's fair to Miss India, Miss Colombia, and Miss Venezuela. We don't want you two to hear the question as I ask Miss Venezuela, so if you two would step back into that soundproof booth back there. And Menorca, if you would, please step right over here. I'm going to ask you the final question, if I can tear it apart. You can tell security is very heavy here. Here's your final question. What for you is the essence of being a woman?
Desde tu punto de vista, ¿qué es la esencia de ser una mujer?
La que nos dio Dios, la esencia de dar amor a todos los seres humanos por igual, principalmente a nuestros hijos, porque es el futuro de todo el universo y además lo más lindo que puede dar una madre, un hijo. Gracias.
The essence that God gave us, which is to give love, because we have to give love to everyone in the universe, especially our children, and that is what we as mothers can do. Thank you.
That's Miss Venezuela. If you'd step right back over here, please, and we bring out Miss India. Sushmita Sen, if you'd stand right here, please. And your question is, what for you is the essence of being a woman?
I think being a woman by itself, the very fact that you're a woman is a gift of God, which all of us must appreciate. The origin of a child is a mother and is a woman. And
And a woman is one who shares love and who shares and shows a man what love, caring, sharing is all about. That is the sense of a woman.
That is Miss India. If you'd step right here, please, and we bring out Miss Colombia. Carolina Gomez, step right here. And your question is, what for you is the essence of being a woman?
The essence of being a woman is not only femininity, but the fact of wanting to live a life, and not only that, but learning out of it and wanting very much to let your children enjoy you as a woman and as a mother.
All right, Miss Colombia, if you'd step right over here, please. Well, now we come to the most difficult moment for our final three contestants and for our judges, too. It's the final vote. As each contestant steps forward, the judges will consider their overall impression of her in the competition this evening, and they will rank each young lady as they vote for her to be the second runner-up, the first runner-up, or the new Miss Universe. We begin with Miss Venezuela, Menorca Mercado. Next, we have Miss India, Sushmita Sen. And finally, Miss Colombia, Carolina Gomez. Ladies and gentlemen, that completes our competition for Miss Universe 1994. One of these three ladies will not only have the thrill of wearing the Miss Universe crown tonight, but she will also take home cash and gifts worth over $225,000. And while we're waiting for our accountants to verify the results, here's Arthel with our reigning Miss Universe, Dayanara Torres, to show you what prizes await our winner.
From stylish Ray-Ban, Miss Universe receives the new Ray-Ban collection for 1994, plus $10,000 cash. Ray-Ban, the official sunglasses for the 1994 Miss Universe delegates. Janssen, official swimwear of the Miss Universe pageant, proudly awards the new Miss Universe $10,000, plus an exciting wardrobe of Janssen swimwear and sportswear. All from Janssen, whose clean water campaign is dedicated to keeping the world's beaches beautiful. From Hawaiian Tropic Sun Care Products, Miss Universe receives a one-week trip to Hawaii for two. Hawaiian Tropic World-Class Sun Protection, available in over 85 countries around the world. Aloha from Hawaiian Tropic. She receives the incomparable Minolta 700SI, a truly interactive camera for those who want total control and creative freedom, plus an array of lenses and accessories, a Minolta camcorder, and the world's first autofocus binoculars, only from the mind of Minolta. A shoe lover's paradise, a dream collection of casual and active footwear for all the fun activities in her life, plus $3,000 cash, all from Payless Shoe Source. Doesn't it feel good to pay less? And Pontiac presents Miss Universe with a sleek new Firebird convertible with outstanding performance, the safety of dual airbags, unmatched value, and one of the most beautiful shapes on the road. The new Firebird convertible truly is driving excitement by Pontiac. She wins a $35,000 shopping spree at Rustan's, the Philippines' premier department store. She'll shop to her heart's content with a personal shopper and wardrobe assistant, all from Rustan's. From Jewelmer, the official South Sea Pearl jeweler for the 1994 Miss Universe pageant, she receives a $10,000 wardrobe of fine pearl jewelry for all special occasions. She wins a $12,000 shopping spree at world-famous Flemington Fur Company. She'll choose from their huge selection of leathers and furs, styled for all occasions, awarded by Flemington Fur Company, Flemington, New Jersey. She receives two first-class tickets on Philippine Airlines to any of their destinations, Asia, Australia, Europe, the Middle East, and the United States, awarded by Philippine Airlines, the official air carrier for the 1994 Miss Universe pageant. She receives $2,000 and a fabulous array of Exclamation fragrance from Coty. Exclamation lets you make a statement without saying a word. Exclamation, the official fragrance of tonight's pageant.
She receives a gorgeous 18-karat gold ladies' watch studded with diamonds from Bertolucci Watch Company. Bertolucci, the finest Italian design, new Swiss classic for the 90s. Designed by Harriman artisan Lauren Pipcorn as a symbol of Miss Universe's reign, the Miss Universe Diamond Signature Brooch, a creation of Harriman New York world-renowned jeweler, dazzling with over 3 carats of diamonds.
Isn't this beautiful? 3 carats.
Oh, 100 diamonds really are dazzling.
Yes, and Harriman New York designed the crown to symbolize the pageant, and it took 6 artisans 2 months to create this.
Well, I hope they get started on ours right away.
Yeah, I'm sure in our dreams, right?
Well, who do you think will wear this tonight? Stay tuned for the finale of the Thrilla from Manila and the new Miss Universe.
Last act of our live broadcast from Manila. As we prepare to crown the new Miss Universe, it is time to say farewell to the young woman from Puerto Rico who has worn the crown so beautifully for the past year. Ladies and gentlemen, for the last time as Miss Universe, here is Dayanara Torres.
Today I give away my crown, but keeping my heart and many memories of this wonderful year. I thank God for giving me the opportunity to be Miss Universe. It was a dream come true to promote Puerto Rico to the world and to help the children of 29 nations I visited. Thank you to the sponsors who gave me the opportunity to continue with my modeling career, to meet so many wonderful people, and to perform in my first movie. Thank you to the Miss Universe staff for their help, and a special gracias to my family for their support, to my friends and the people of my country. Thank you for helping me to realize my greatest goal. Just remember, no matter where I am, I always be proud to have been born in my lindo Puerto Rico.
Dayanara, thank you so much. You've worn the crown beautifully for the past year. You've made us all very proud, and we wish you the best of luck in the future. Well, ladies, this is it. This is the moment. Now is the time to crown the second runner-up, the first runner-up, and the new Miss Universe. The accounting firm of Ernst & Young has reviewed the results, and Mark Ward has the results for me. Now, to assist us also, we have two beautiful women who know the excitement of this moment very well. The two former Miss Universe title holders from the Philippines, Gloria Diaz and Margarita Moran. Well, ladies, you are all winners, and you have represented your countries beautifully. But now, only one can win the title of Miss Universe. Good luck to all three of you. The second runner-up is Miss Venezuela, Menorca Mercado. Come on, ladies. Come on. Oh, boy. Now, as I'm about to reveal the name of the first runner-up, remember that the role of the first runner-up is very important, because should anything happen to Miss Universe for any reason, the first runner-up will continue in her reign. So good luck to both of you. The first runner-up is Miss Colombia. That means Sushmita Sen, Miss India. You are the new Miss Universe 1994. Congratulations, Miss India. Sushmita Sen, you are the new Miss Universe 1994. The stage is yours for the traditional walk as the new Miss Universe. Enjoy your moment.
You are.
Congratulations to Shusmita Sen. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope that you will join us for the Miss Teen USA pageant from Mississippi Beach on August 16th, right here on CBS. On behalf of Arthel Neville, Bebo Bryson, Angela Visser, this is Bob Goen saying thank you for joining us from Manila in the Philippines. Good night, everybody.
Get ready for an hour of magical television. Carol Burnett, The Special Years. Classic moments with Julie Andrews, Lucille Ball, Placido Domingo, Whoopi Goldberg, Dolly Parton, and a whole lot more. Carol Burnett hosts The Special Hour next.